Hi, in this video, I am going to be talking about the relationship between breast cancer and Li-Fraumeni syndrome. This video is being produced at the request of one of the people who dropped a comment in our previous videos. Before I go on, I'd love to invite you to subscribe to our channel. We put out 3 videos a week and we're always producing new content. I also want to invite you to go to yerbba.com to get your personalized report. Li-Fraumeni syndrome is a very rare genetic condition that we see in about 1 in 5,000 people to as uncommon or as rare as 1 in 20,000 people. It's thought that about 50,000 people in the United States are living with Li-Fraumeni syndrome. The syndrome was first described in 1969 by Drs. Li and Fraumeni at the National Cancer Institute. This is a genetic syndrome, meaning it's inherited from one parent or the other. I'm going to talk for a moment about the inheritance pattern because it's really helpful to understand how this gene is passed on. Li-Fraumeni syndrome is due to a mutation in the TP53 gene, which codes for a protein that is supposed to stop tumor cells from developing and growing. And it's inherited as an autosomal dominant pattern. What that means is if somebody has the gene, they have a 50-50 chance of passing it to each of their children. If they have one child who inherits the gene, it's independent whether the other child has the gene. So, for example, if you have a sibling who has a Li-Fraumeni syndrome, you have a 50-50 chance of having it. Your risk is not lower than that, and it's not higher than that. Similarly, if you have, let's say, a second-degree relative, like an aunt who's related to you through blood, and your aunt has Li-Fraumeni syndrome, that means that she got that from one of your grandparents and that your parent, who's the sister of your aunt, has a 50-50 chance of having it. If your aunt has Li-Fraumeni syndrome, really your parent should be tested before you're tested, if possible, because then we know what we're looking for. We know if you even need to have counseling and testing. If people have the syndrome, it's not something they did wrong. Passing this on to your children is not something you did wrong. It's just a random event, and it's quite rare, again, but obviously not rare enough. If you have this gene in your family, you are aware that it's associated with multiple different types of cancer. We've talked before about the importance of your family history. We'll drop a link to that video. But it's really important to share your family history with your medical team, starting with your primary care doctor. If there are multiple cancers in your family, you may be eligible for genetic counseling and testing, depending on the cancers in particular. People with the Li-Fraumeni syndrome have nearly a 100% chance, if they're female, of getting breast cancer. So that's why it's so important to understand this syndrome. If you have Li-Fraumeni syndrome, there are things that we can do. We can do surveillance, which would differ from screening mammography. We would most likely, depends on your particular situation, we would include MRIs as a screening modality along with mammograms, because we want to detect, if possible, the cancer early. When people are diagnosed with breast cancer related to Li-Fraumeni syndrome, it does tend to be more active. I'm careful not to use the word aggressive, but people tend to be diagnosed with more advanced disease, so a bigger tumor, more positive nodes, for example. And that's in part because the age of onset is lower, so people with Li-Fraumeni syndrome can get breast cancer in their 20s or 30s, and cancers in younger people tend to be a little more active. And if they're not engaging in surveillance scans like mammography and MRIs or ultrasounds in very young people, we try to avoid mammograms, we're not going to be able to detect it early. I know this is a lot of information. Again, this is a really rare syndrome. If you have it, it's very important. You will also likely be offered surveillance and screening for other cancers associated with the syndrome. We try to be as proactive as we can. all the other things we've said about scans and MRIs that in the general population don't apply to people with Li-Fraumeni syndrome. It's a special situation in which we do a lot more testing. Obviously, that's a bigger burden on you in terms of appointments and the anxiety of having tests. So I do want to acknowledge that. I really thank the viewer who asked us to cover this syndrome. I hope this has been helpful. If you have a question or a comment, you can drop it below. Recall that we can't give medical advice, but we can give general information if you ask a question, and sharing your experience is great for other people watching these videos. Thanks for watching.